Alright, this is the roof we got going today. She's a steep one. Zoom out here. Show you guys. It is a 12-12. I think it's about 38 squares plus ridge. But you can see that's a steep house. Boys are up there. They're harnessed up, which they rarely do, so you know it's steep when the Hispanic crew's wearing their ropes and harnesses. But let's go about in the back and see what they got going. They're going to start from the back and work their way forward. Oh. Let's just see here. It's about 7:30 in the morning on a Wednesday. I think it's November 10th and 9th, I'm not sure. There's a satellite we're gonna get rid of. Oh. Yep, that's a steep roof, boys. 12-12. Here and show you this side over here. I'm glad I'm too old to be up on those anymore. When I first started roofing 30 something years ago, that's all we did was steep. And that was in East Tennessee, and everything was built on hillsides. So usually the back side of the house would be 40, 50 feet off the ground. Some scary stuff. But these boys will get this door off and get a roof back in. Hopefully we'll have this done by Friday, maybe Saturday morning. We'll see. Alright. Boys have got some of that off. They're just getting that off by hanging from ropes. You know, you wouldn't catch me up there right now. I just don't trust the old legs like I used to. All these boys are fairly young. I think that dude over there is the oldest one. He's got to be in like his mid-30s or something. But all these guys right here are either 30 or under, I think. Now he's getting out on that field. Look at him go. That guy right there, that's the one who just migrated here. Doing it legal, but is the first 12-12 roof he's ever been on. He's normally a painter. I think he was in Honduras or Ecuador, one of the two of those. He's doing pretty good for his first 12-12. This guy here, he's not a fast mover, but that guy is consistent all day. Not the fastest nailer, but he's consistent all day, which is good, because if you go trying to go too fast, I'll be honest with you guys, you get to be my age, you won't be roofing no more. I started pacing myself probably in my young 30s. Quit risking, taking chances and risking my health on them roofs. I took a pretty good fall when I was younger, fell 27 feet and broke both legs. Just for an idea how high 27 feet is. It was higher than that peak over there. It's probably about the top up there. That's about 27 feet to the ground, right behind that tree where the ridge is. So, I stepped on frost on the back of a house like this, and it was papered in with a black paper. I couldn't see the frost, and I stepped over the peak and slid all the way down, so I had a run and go before I dropped 27 feet. Shot off the house like a rocket. just wanted to show you guys they've got that much off. It's been about probably 30 minutes since my last clip. Hey, boys, got this all off on the back. They're about to start throwing some underlayment on, putting the ice guard in the valley right there. You won't see me up on this roof like you did the last one, because I am not getting up there. Maybe I'll get up there for the final inspection, but that's about it, and I even doubt that. Hey, Reuben, how's that transition look between that low slope and that other?
What do you mean?
Where that low slope meets that roof, is there a hump or?
No, it's just.
You probably should put some ice guard right where that transition is. I'm gonna take off. I gotta go look at a couple roofs. Leave these boys to themselves. Pick up these tools when they get lost in the leaves. I used to find tools all the time when I did new construction, because I'd walk the job sites at the end of the day for shit people lost on the ground. Let's get my toolbox here. I had to go pick up some material, so I took it out of the truck. Anyhow, I'll come back over here a few hours. I just live right down the road and see how the boys are doing. All right, boys are roofing her back in, Lisa's backside. We've got that triangle done. He's about up that valley and about has it done. And Reuben will jump over here. He'll have that knocked out in no time. Old Reuben there, pretty fast roofer. We don't claim to be the world's fastest roofer like you see a lot of videos. I could care less how fast the guys went. I'd rather them go slow, take their time, pay attention to what they're doing. Never in a hurry to get a roof done, really. I've got one more house after this, and hopefully I can take the winter off from roofing whole houses. I mean, I still do repairs, and I also do handyman stuff. Helps pay the bills in the winter. Guys coming up that side right over there. Looking good. Finally starting on this big part of the back. So that guy there, he goes to immigration today. He's working on his green card. Reuben's already a citizen. I think that dude in the fluorescent's already a citizen. So just shows you, man, it's not hard to become a citizen in this country if you do it right. sliding them down from the top. This guy over here is chucking them to him. By the time they get, they're going to get that done there, which they've already got done, this done. He's already coming up this other side some. And then they're going to get that flatter deck up there where that guy's standing right there. Eddie's his name. Where Eddie's standing. They'll get that. And then they'll call it a day. Notice how he doesn't lean the ladder on the edge metal there. That's my ladder they're using. I'll be back. The boys are on the big part of the back now. Running the bottom five or six, seven shingles, so Reuben has somewhere to stand and can finish going up that run up through there. But I'm gonna go take a lunch, so I'll be back in a bit. All right, it's about 3 p.m. Boys have got that back done, that side done. I believe they got this around the corner done. Yes, they sure do. Now they're up there on that flat deck. Or flatter, it's not flat. Let me rephrase that. I think it's about a 3.5-12. Got that eyebrow run to do up this side. Reuben's cutting some wood for up there. Boys are up there beating down nails right now. Did you get Juanito to immigration?
Yeah. Help me out here.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's there.
Maybe they're deporting him, huh? They're like, we're tired of your ass.
I hope not.
What, is he from Mexico or?
Salvador.
El Salvador? Yep, he's on a plane right now. First class to El Salvador. So yeah, it's Wednesday. Hoping to have this thing knocked out by Friday evening. At the rate they're going, shouldn't be a problem. This is the last time I'm going to check on them today. Probably need to take some of that ice guard back. We got a little bit too much. I'm going to move my truck into the driveway and load up a few of those. I'll see you guys in the morning. All right, back at the roof. It's about 8:30 in the morning. I had to go run to the supply before I came here this morning. Eddie there cleaning up the ground. We're on the west side of the house now. Ruben's got this all prepped. We're bringing some material over because the supply house did a shitty load on this house and put everything towards the front. I'd say you got about 15 more squares to go. There's Reuben up there. Let's walk around the house here and see what's going on. Trailer's freaking full. He's gonna go dump that. So he's got the eyebrow tore off, and then that. So looks like the top is done up there. Good to see it's got some heavy duty galvanized flashing in it. But these boys will have this job wrapped up by tomorrow afternoon, hopefully. Saturday it's supposed to get really cold here, and then we got a couple chances of snow, believe it or not, next week. So I don't have any roof scheduled next week, but I have a little house after next week, so hopefully it'll warm back up a little bit before we get on that little house. Otherwise, it's going to be some cold roofing. The good thing about the little house, it don't have no valleys to bend shingles around in the cold. It's just a straight little box house, probably about 15 squares or so, if I remember right. But I'll be back when these guys are shooting. Boys have started shooting that on. Reuben's freaking crazy being on that 12-12 with no rope. But it's his legs. He'll learn one day like I did. But I've got to go look at a couple roofs, so I'm going to take off from the job for an hour or two. Alright, it's about 11:30. Been about an hour and a half since I've been here. Looks like the boys got that side done. They still got that upper portion up there, which I think they're gonna do tomorrow. Let's walk over here and see what's going on. Still haven't done the eyebrow. All right, we're ridge capping. Cap. The far side of your cap. Good. The this ground cleaned up back here. Looking good. What we got over here? We got some cherry tomatoes going.
Yeah.
Nice little cherry tomatoes. Might try and climb up there here in a second. Gotta get some loppers out of my truck for these branches up here. Get them cut back away from the roof a little bit. Looks like they're gonna do this part right here too, so. I shall be back. All right, I'm back at the job site. It's about 3:30, maybe a little after 3:30, but man, the temperature sure has dropped in the past hour. You know, we're a couple hours east of Oklahoma City, and I guess Oklahoma City's getting hammered by some serious storms. And they're heading this way. Usually stuff in Oklahoma City takes 2 or 3 hours to get here, but it was bright sunny this morning, and I'm looking towards Oklahoma City right over in that direction. So it's a coming. The boys are gonna button everything up, make sure it's watertight for the night. They're gonna finish that side where this guy's nailing right here. They've already did that upper deck up there where the guy in the fluorescent shirt is. And they've got a little bit tore off the front here. And this is day two of this job. And Ruben's getting ready to get on that little eyebrow right there and go up. Which he's gonna do with no ladder, he said. So we will see. So in the morning, we'll have this section here, which goes up a little bit around the side of that dormer. Come across the front of this pop-out dormer here, and then this side and that upper. So that's probably about a half a day's work for them, a little bit more. But I'm going to film Ruben risking his life on that thing right there. When he gets in position and gets ready to start nailing, I'll be back. Hey, Ruben's up there starting that eyebrow off. Boys have finished this side over here. Maybe I'll go up there. There's a rope perfect to go up there with. Yeah, I think I'm gonna climb up there. Be back in a minute. So I made it up on the roof. You don't think this is steep? It's straight up and down. Pulled myself up here with a rope. Ah, first time I've been up on a 12-12 in a long time. About 8:45 in the morning. I just got here. I had to run to the supply and pick up some more edge metal. But what a difference a day makes. Yesterday it was in the mid 70s here, and today it's like 40, 35, 40 degrees. It is freaking chilly. Whew, it's gonna take me a week or two to adjust to this crap. But the boys have got just about all that off the front that we had left over yesterday. go get this house roofed back in today, and I'll be back later. Boys are getting the underlayment on. They'll have this roofed in a few hours. It is chilly today. A minute ago, I stopped at the store, and I never buy scratch-off lottery tickets. I mean, I probably only bought them 3 or 4 times in my life. And I stopped the store a minute ago to get a biscuit. Bought a scratcher for $10 and hit it for $200. So I'm gonna go home and sit in the warmth for a little bit and come back when these boys are done. All right, I'm back at the roof. It looks like the boys are at lunch. They're down to, I'd say, probably about 4.5-5 squares, and they'll be done with this house. A little bit of ridge cap, but I've got to go run and look at some roofs, and then I will come back by, and they will probably be about done by the time I get back, depending on how long they stay at lunch. Till then. All right, boys are down to the last square. They've got about 99% of the ridge on. They only got a ridge right there where they're roofing. So up from that V there, up to that peak, and down to that other peak, and that's all the ridge they got left. They're down to the last square. It's about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Still cold as hell. It'll be really cold tomorrow. That is Reuben. Wilmer's funny. Well, we got a couple squares of material left. Roll the underlayment. Probably come back in the morning just to get the final shot, but till tomorrow. All right, it's Saturday morning. I'm just at the job to inspect it and make sure it looks good for the customer. Woke up this morning, and as you can see, there will be no getting up on the roof and inspecting it today. Got a little bit of snow last night. Fucking cold as hell right now. So we're gonna pull the signs out of the yard, pick up the little bit of extra material that's still here. But I promise you, there's a good looking roof under that snow. I think the other side's a little defrosted. We'll go over there and take a look at it. Oh gosh, it's cold. I'm not ready for winter. Oh. That's the leftover material on this cut-up job, so that's pretty good. But yeah, this side's a little bit more defrosted, but not much to look at when it's snowed up like this. So I'm gonna load up this stuff, and I appreciate you guys watching my videos. If you could like and subscribe, I would appreciate it. It helps my channel grow. Until the next one, I think I got another one in about a week or two.